we've definitely killed a lot of plants as well in order to get to this point. And it's part of that process. It's part of that journey that we've kind of both been on, learning about our particular space and what works here. I'm James Barela.
I'm Ray Delgadillo.
And 5 years ago, we built this garden from scratch.
At the time, we were really interested in English cottage gardens, and so we wanted something very peaceful. My day job is being a product designer. James is a freelance designer, and he's a working artist. And so I think we approached gardening as a creative outlet.
So the first thing we did to the backyard was to install a retaining wall. That was the very first thing we wanted to do because it was so foundational to the entire garden.
I decided to build a deck out of Trex to keep it very low maintenance. It's a composite material. It's half wood, half plastic. And so it's supposed to last up to 25 years without any maintenance.
So we built the raised beds with the same material as well. So hopefully they'll last several years. The other option was cedar, but we had some friends that had some extra Trex, so that's kind of how we started the whole process. The material for our retaining wall is a concrete product. We started to learn a lot about retaining walls.
They came with a spec guide for different types of soil and how to build a foundation and build a drainage behind it. And so they lock with fiberglass pins. It's dry stack, so it can drain. There's about 10 cubic feet of stone behind the wall, which is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Actually, cubic yards.
The construction of the wall took about 6 months of weekends for us, but it was a wonderful challenge that I think both of us really were really proud of, and we really wanted to accomplish this.
It was so much work, but it was fun in the end.
We had a lot of that extra loam that we created when we were building the wall, so we were kind of loading it up in different parts of the yard. It was very, very rich. It was almost like black soil at that point once all the sod decomposed. So we used that, mixed it with native soil, and then we added compost, dillo dirt, and some topsoil.
A lot of our garden, we started from seed, and then we'll buy things that just naturally interest us, either the flower color or the structure.
We'll often like collect seed 1 year, and then we'll basically use all that seed for the next planting. Sometimes we've also taken cuttings from a plant that we really like and really kind of save those cuttings, make sure you bring them inside during the winter. So for privacy, because this was a blank slate out here, we had to think about that. And we originally started with clumping bamboo. Unfortunately, with the past couple of years, it was really, really stressful for the clumping bamboo. I think at this point, we're going to replace them with something different.
Well, I think one of the most challenging things about this property is how exposed it is. We're on a hillside, and so anytime there's a windstorm, it feels so much more intense than anywhere in Austin we have lived. So we wanted to address not only the privacy, but the wind.
We did get a couple of magnolias. This variety is called DD Blanchard, and it's supposed to be a lot more vertical. We've also tried Scarlet's Peak, hollies, which are really, really wonderful. And we also have a nice peach tree. And try to create sort of rooms and divide the space a lot more because it just becomes a lot more manageable.
I think we've also used color to help tie the garden together.
We wanted there to be a lot of color around this patio because we were going to be able to see it from the inside of the house as well. And then we do spend a lot of time on this deck. In this garden, we have standing cypress, we have cosmos, columbine, rubeckia maxima. There's a couple of scabiosas, the ones that I saved over from fall as cuttings, and I brought them back into this bed, and more columbines, because I really love columbines.
And I think all of this bed was grown from seed.
Our cat will kind of just watch through the window, and birds will come visit the little fountain right there, the little water garden. Our cat will just watch it and, you know, just kind of be enjoying the little butterflies in the area.
This border behind us is actually, it doesn't get any irrigation. We water by hand every once in a while in the summer. We started by picking plants that were just really tough, nepeta or catmint, roses. A lot of people think roses are not drought tolerant, but they've been really good for us, especially English roses. Monarda, salvia. Salvia Blue Victory has done amazing in this garden. And there's so many varieties of salvias. We probably have six or seven in the garden. Angelonias, Russian sage.
There's tons of butterflies that visit this area. We have bees, all different types of bees. We have native bees that come by. The garden gets full of annuals. We have Texas horned lizards as well. Just a lot of wildlife that I think wouldn't necessarily be here if it wasn't for all these places for them to kind of interact with and for pollinators to come by. We're trying to also do a lot of like succession planting. So when something is finished blooming, we want to make sure that there's something behind it that's going to refresh that when that plant is done. So a few years ago, I started with ceramics, and I really wanted to create my own containers for my plants. Since then, I've actually become really inspired, you know, during this process of building this new garden, and now I start seeing some of the forms in some of my plants, in influencing the way that I work now. And the process of gardening is very much similar to the process of ceramics. They're both very meditative and they're both creative. You kind of have those moments where you lose track of time.
My work is sitting on the computer all day. And so gardening complements kind of my creative side by allowing me to do something meditative that takes me away from the computer and allows me to just get lost into something that is also creative.
In the very front, we have what we've called the Devil Strip. Some areas call it different names, but I really love the name Devil Strip because it is like a devil to plant there. It's constantly dry, so you really have to choose plants that can handle the radiant heat from the concrete, and there's also no irrigation in that area. In the other garden next to it, we have, you know, coreopsis, sea holly. We've used Brazos penstemon or Gulf penstemon, which has been really reliable. We also have some of the Rudbeckia maximas in the front there.
Overall, I think we both really like informal plantings.
Yeah.
But you also have to be aware that it can look a little wild. And so we like to insert elements of thoughtfulness to kind of clean it up and make it sharp, have some elements that are sharp.
In the center of one of the beds, we also have a smoke bush, royal purple, and that's kind of like the big anchor in that area where everything kind of circles around that. We really want to bring in some just like interesting textures and variety to the area.
We try to emulate nature as much as we can, which is actually really difficult. We're next to a really busy road. It's western facing, and so it gets the really hot afternoon sun. It also has no irrigation. We do water it every once in a while in the summer, but we wanted to choose natives that were really tough. So we have big muley, we have indigo spire salvia, we have salvia greggii, which always, that one does well all across the garden. We also planted a few Mexican feathergrasses a few years ago, and they've been slowly spreading into kind of a carpet effect. We also have Rudbeckias. I personally think of gardening as kind of like painting with plants, and you have to think about the seasons and how they change and how the colors evolve.
It's kind of just been this nice thing for us to kind of explore together. We're both very curious people, so we kind of both latched onto this relatively quickly, and I think it's been a really nice journey for both of us to kind of go on.